Hello guys, welcome to my YouTube channel Smart Learning 24/7. And in my today's video, I'll be starting up with a new lecture series on the topic reconciliation of cost and financial accounts. And before I proceed on with the subject, let me remind you one thing. If you would like to get notifications of my forthcoming videos, then please do subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon. So now moving on with our very first question in this topic. So the question is like this: from the following, prepare a reconciliation statement between cost and financial records. Net profit as per financial records 128,755. So as usual, we have been given this information. So if you look into this topic by name called reconciliation of cost and financial accounts, so this particular topic, it has so much of similarity with that of your bank reconciliation statement. I hope you might have got an idea regarding bank reconciliation statement topic. And this particular topic also has got so much of similarity or so much of relevance with regard to your BRS or bank reconciliation statement. And in the case of your BRS, when you prepared your bank reconciliation statement, you might have used two different books. One might have been your passbook and other might have been your cash book. And over here we'll be again having two different bases. One will be your information relating to your costing records, and the other will be the information relating to your financial records. So this will be the information, okay? And based on the question, like, you will be given both the information. That is, if you just have a look at this very particular question, you have been given in this question net profit as per financial records and also net profit as per costing records. Both information is being given to us. Okay, so it's your discretion. Actually, you can choose any of the books as your base. It can be costing records or it can be financial records also. Okay, since we are doing up with the cost accounting subject, so the better option will always be to choose the costing records as your base. Okay, so now quickly we'll move on with the steps or the solution part of this particular question. That is, the very first thing which has been given to us is net profit as per financial records, which is 128,755. So this information, we'll keep this in hold. Then moving on, net profit as per costing records 1,72,400. Okay, so this is the very first information which we will write in our solution part. So when you are about to start up with the solution for this, your format of your reconciliation statement will be somewhat like this. Okay, first and foremost thing, you got to give a heading, which is a reconciliation statement, and it will comprise of three columns. That is, the first column will be your particulars column, second column will be your rupees column, and third column will be your rupees column again. Okay, and already I have told you from the question, we'll be using the very first information, which is net profit as per costing records. That is, this costing records will be our base for now. Okay, so profit as per costing record, which is 1,72,400, we have written this directly in our outer column. Okay, then moving on with the next information, which is works overhead under recovered in costing. Works overhead under recovered in costing, which is 3,120, they have told. Okay, so hope that you know the differentiation between over recovered and under recovered. Under recovered in the sense the amount has been recovered less, it is not recovered in excess, but it has been recovered less. So that will be the basic understanding of this particular word or this term. So works overhead under recovered in costing 3,120. So when it comes to under recovered, so when we have got this costing record as our base, then under recovered elements in your costing, that has to be deducted. Okay, so whichever information is recovered in less, then that has to be deducted from the information. So what you will have to do is, like, over here I have clearly mentioned, that is, there are two different signs which are visible. One is plus, positive sign, and there is negative sign, minus. Okay, and the very first information, works overhead under recovered in costing, I have written it in the negative place, or at the by indicating the minus symbol, I have written this value, which is 3120. Okay. Now moving on, the next information which has been given to us is administrative overhead recovered in excess 1700. So recovered in excess in the sense it is a surplus or abundance. So when it is surplus and abundance, that obviously it will be your positive value. So positive value, actually what you will have to do, you will have to add this with your costing records. So that's why administrative overhead is recovered in excess, which is 1700. You are adding this over here. Then moving on with the next thing, which is depreciation charged in financial records, 11,200. So hopefully you know the meaning of charge. Charge means like you have been levied or you are incurring an expenditure, something of that sort. So over here you have been clearly indicated it is financial record. Okay, so when it comes to financial record, like you may have a confusion, our base book is costing record and over here we have been given financial record. So should we add this amount? You may have a doubt. No, because whatever is happening in the financial records, obviously it has to get updated in your costing records also. So that is why this depreciation charge in financial records of 11,200. So since this is charge which happens to be an expenditure, then you should deduct this from your costing records. Okay, so depreciation charge 11,200, you are deducting this from your costing record. Okay, then moving on with the next element, which is depreciation recovered in costing. Recovered in the sense we are getting the amount or it's a kind of income. So when you are generating any kind of income, then obviously it is a positive element. So that is why in our solution part, depreciation recovered 12,500 in your positive part, you are showing this as a value. Okay, then moving on with the next thing, which is interest received but not included in costing. Interest received but not included in costing. So this particular sentence, like, it has got a bit of confusion. Interest received but not included in costing. So once you receive your interest, it is quite obvious that the amount will be increasing. It's a kind of an income. So when it comes to income, obviously it is a positive value. Okay, but not included in costing, that particular statement, it need not be given the due importance. So the prime importance has to be given to this term, which is interest received, which is 8,000. So when you are receiving, it's a kind of income. So obviously it is an addition thing. Okay, so interest received 8,000, it has to be added. Then moving on with the next thing, which is loss charged in financial records. Okay, loss charged in financial records, it is an expenditure, so obviously it has to be deducted. So obsolescence loss charge, which is 5700, we are showing this as a negative value. Okay, then the next thing is income tax provided in financial books. So income tax also is an expenditure, so we are deducting this value, which is 40,300. Then bank interest credited in financial books. Credited in financial books, again you may have a doubt, it is financial book. We have taken cost records as our base. Nothing to worry, even if it is your financial book or costing book, if it is getting updated in one particular book, definitely it will be updated in the alternate book as well. So that is why, so the thing is that bank interest credited in financial books, definitely it will have a indication in your cost books also. So that is why you will have to add this. So bank interest 750, we are adding this. Okay, then moving on, stores adjustment credit in financial books. Credit, again it is a positive thing. So stores adjustment, which is 475, we are adding this. And then the next thing will be depreciation of stock charged in financial books. Stock charged. Charge is actually an expenditure. So it has to be deducted, which is 6,750 rupees. Okay, so all the information which has been given to us in the question, we have included this, except the very first thing, which is net profit as per financial records. I'll tell you where we'll be using this information a bit later. So for now, we have shown all the information or all the elements in the respective places. That is, if there were a few things to be added, we have added that, and there were a few things which were to be deducted, we have deducted that. And after doing up with the due additions and deductions, like what you will have to do is, like in the inner column, you can add up all the values, and after adding all these values, you get 23,425 as the final total of your inner column. Then with the already available value in the outer column, we are adding this inner column value. Then we are getting our final value of positive values to be 1,95,825. And from this value, you got to deduct your negatives, which you have got in the inner column. So if we add all the negative values, we get 67,070 as the negative values. So from this 195,825, if you deduct the 67,070, you get your final answer to be 128,755. And what is this 128,755? I'll just show you the question again. So if you look into the starting point, net profit as per financial records, 128,755. And the final answer which we have got over here is 128,755. So this is an indication that by using one particular record as your base, you are getting the alternate record as the final answer. Okay, so in this very particular topic, you can easily verify with your answer because you have already been given this particular information. So the verification work, it tends to be a simpler work. Okay, so with this, the solution part of this question is coming to an end. Hope that you might have understood the workings of this particular question. And if you have got any queries regarding this particular question, feel free and leave a comment in the comment box section so that I can give you the clarifications as to what are the various things to be done with regard to your queries. So thank you one and all. And again, I remind you, if you would like to get notifications of my further videos, please do subscribe and hit the bell icon so that you can stay connected to my YouTube channel. Thank you one and all.